The Electrom Power Pack is the only truly portable lightweight power pack on the market. Today we will be testing a 6.6 kV stator, and we have a iTIG 3D model to drive the power pack. The power pack comes with one high voltage output lead. So that's the red clip. It has two black high voltage returns used during the surge test, and one frame ground. It also comes with a communication cable. This is how the power pack talks to the iTIG, or vice versa. Take the power pack end, connect it to the accessories port on the power pack. Take the other end to the accessories port on the iTIG. And we're now ready to start the setup. Similar to the operation of the iTIG 2 and 3, you click start. Select the motor you want to test from the motor test list. Say test. Again, similar to what you're used to from the iTIG 2s and 3s, we get to our test summary screen. We can enter in a test description. In our case, we will be testing a stator today. You can also enter in a test stage. We're just going to leave that blank for today, and operator information. Next up would be the setup screen. Similar to the iTIG 2s and 3s, the default Hipot and surge test voltage formula is 2 times operating voltage plus 1000. For this 6.6 kV motor, that means we're at 14,200. If you want to change any of these, you can do so. If we were testing this motor in the field or in your workshop, you probably would want to do the low voltage measurements, and this is when you would do so. So you would go ahead and use the iTIG to complete your winding resistance, CLC measurements if you have them, and megohm measurements. The reason why we say to do the megohm measurement with the iTIG as opposed to doing it with the power pack is due to the increase in resolution and accuracy with the iTIG, especially with the iTIG 3. Since we're using a power pack for this demonstration, we will assume that we've passed the low voltage measurements and just move on to the Hipot and surge test. So we go to our auto mode and limits setup screen. For Hipot, you can use the drop down menu to select what test profile to use. For this demonstration, we will use a 5-point step test. You have the option of doing a 10-point step test or a ramp test. You can also do a 1-point Hipot. However, with a power pack testing to high voltage, it's generally speaking recommended to do either a step test or a ramp test. If you have a D model, you can program and add to this list of test profiles. Save mode test configuration, exit setup, click the power pack button to enable the power pack. When it's green, when the button is green, it means the iTIG is communicating with the power pack and we're ready to start testing. As you can see, the number of tabs along the bottom row is reduced when the power pack is connected. That means the low voltage measurements are now removed because the power pack is only used for the high voltage testing. So if we move one tab over, we get to our megohm and Hipot screen. Again, we recommend using the iTIG 3 for the megohm measurement because of the increase in resolution and accuracy. So we will move on to the Hipot test. You click auto mode. It tells you in the bottom left corner which test profile has been selected. We selected the 5-point step test. Next step would be to connect the test leads to the motor. So, like we mentioned initially, we have a frame ground or ground clip. Connect that to an unpainted clean surface on the frame or a bolt like this. The high voltage returns or ground leads, you can just leave on the ground or hang it in air at this point. We will only use the red high voltage lead. Since this is a three-phase start connected motor. We can connect to either phase 1, 2, and 3. We're going to connect to phase 1 and just leave the two other ones open. Now we're ready to start the test. Make sure the test area is safe. Nobody's touching the motor, standing too close. And you press the red button on the power pack to start the test set. With the 5-point step test, the 14,200 volts will be broken down into 5 equal steps. And the tester will automatically increase the voltage to 1/5 of our design test voltage. It will sit there for 1 minute, make the measurement, and then move on to the next step. After 1 minute has passed, it will ramp up to 2/5 of our design test voltage. Again, you can see the leakage current accelerates and then reaches sort of a peak and starts decaying again. Another minute has passed and we're ramping up to 3/5 of our design test voltage. The fourth step in our 5-point step test. Sit there for 1 more minute before we do the last ramp sequence. So that's our last, fifth and final step to get to 14,200 volts. We now have 5 peaks. You can see them in the chart as well. And the test has concluded. So after the 5 steps and sitting at 1 minute, at the last step we got about 10 microamps of leakage, which is okay. There is nothing wrong with the main insulation in this stator. And the tester will now automatically discharge the windings. This may take a while because of the large insulation system. That's the Hipot test. At the conclusion of the Hipot test, we're ready to move on to the surge test. The surge test is very similar to what you're used to from the iTIG. It's done in the manual fashion, since the power pack only has one high voltage output lead. It will start with phase 1. So phase 1 is highlighted green in the top right corner. We will connect the test leads in such a way that we have the red lead connected to phase 1 and the 2 high voltage returns or ground leads to phase 3 and phase 2. Enable the instrument and use the red button on the power pack to start the test. Similar to the iTIGs, it will automatically scale the time base and voltage scale and drive the voltage up to our design test voltage. This takes a little bit longer for phase 1, so it recognizes the settings, and it will be much quicker in phase 2 and 3. Okay, so we're done with phase 1. We can now move the leads and connect to phase 2. Take the red high voltage lead, move it to phase 2, and the ground clip to phase 1. Select phase 2, arm the instrument, and press the red button on the power pack. Tester now knows what voltage to bring the test up to, and it has the oscilloscope settings, so the test is very quick. We do the same thing with phase 3, so move the high voltage lead from phase 2 to phase 3. And ground clip to phase 2. On the tester, select phase 3, arm the instrument, press the red button. And we're done. The test is good. You can see the 3 phases are nice and neatly overlapped. Largest percent wave difference is 4.4%. That's great. We are now done with our test set. We can go to the test summary screen and we'll get our pass-fail recommendations for the tests that we've done. We didn't do the low voltage measurements for this demonstration, but if you did so with the iTIG, they would show up on this list as well. At the conclusion of the test, when you're happy and ready to move on, you go back to the setup screen, disable the power pack, press the folder button. All the information is automatically stored. There's no save operation. And you can now go and print reports and move on to your next test like you're used to with the iTIG 3.